The Nokia 8 isn't just the first Nokia flagship to pack a bit of Android OS, it's also the first to rock a dual lens camera, or dual sight as HMD Global has termed it. Here's our full review. First of all, you can call up the camera with a quick double tap of the Nokia 8's power button, which is handy if you want to take a spontaneous shot. From the main camera UI, you can take a snap with a touch of the shutter button, or switch to video mode if you'd rather catch a home movie. You also have a number of toggles available along the left edge. From here you can turn the flash on or off, add a timer function and change which camera lenses are used for photo capture. For instance, by default the Nokia 8 takes snaps using both of those rear lenses, one of them a 30 megapixel colour and the other a 30 megapixel monochrome. However, you can also choose to use just one at a time or swap to the front facing 13 meg snapper for a sexy selfie. Ladies and gentlemen, if you thought that a Griffy was bad, say hello to the Bothie. Of course, this is a feature we've seen on other phones before, including Samsung's handsets from back in the day, and it certainly does what it says on the tin, although it drastically narrows how much you can actually capture with that rear shooter. A very subtle camera modes button sits next to the shutter and opens up even more functions. From this menu, you can shoot panorama images, swap to beauty mode, which smoothens out your subject's skin, and even call up the Nokia 8's manual controls, which is handy if you're a pro photographer who wants very precise results. Last but not least, you'll find a live bokeh mode. This blurs the background by using both camera lenses to focus on your subject, which is a common feature found on dual lens mobile snappers. You can choose the degree of the effect from a subtle blur into a full on bokeh, with instant feedback on the screen before you take your snap. This really helps your subject to stand out without softening them around the edges, which is a common issue with this kind of feature. The Nokia 8's phase detection autofocus locks onto your subject without delay, as long as the lighting conditions aren't too troublesome. You can then take photos instantly with a tap of the shutter button. Tapping quickly takes lots of snaps in quick succession, or you can also just hold your finger on the button to activate the Nokia 8's burst mode. We did see the occasional little episode where the camera struggled to focus, even in quite respectable lighting conditions. This appears to be a software issue, so hopefully will be fixed in a future update. Still, as you'd expect from a flagship phone, the Nokia 8's camera does a fine job of capturing images when the conditions are good. Detail levels are strong, with the two camera lenses combining to capture a nice crisp scene. The built-in HDR does a good job with high contrast situations, avoiding ugly murky results as well as any nasty oversaturation. That's good news if you want a camera for shooting monuments and other touristy stuff in very sunny destinations. In seriously low light, the Nokia 8 can't quite perform to the level of the HTC U11 or the OnePlus 5 of course. You'll still get some perfectly usable shots in everything but extreme darkness though. Some of our night snaps taken in central London were quite soft and occasionally grainy, although that OIS does help to eliminate any judder and blur that we probably would have otherwise seen. Swap to that front-facing 13 megapixel camera and you can expect similarly decent results. There's a screen flash mode for night shots which just about lights up your face without making you look like a spectre. Switch to video mode and you can once again capture footage with a combination of those three cameras. And you can also shoot time-lapse or slow motion video. Good news if you like sharing your existence with the world as well, because the Nokia 8 allows you to live stream video straight to Facebook or YouTube via the camera app. Whether you're shooting full HD or 4K resolution video, you can expect some pretty decent image stabilization too. The Nokia 8 isn't quite as strong as the OnePlus 5 post-update or the Xperia XZ Premium, yet it still does a better job than the likes of the HTC U11 of reducing shake and judder from motion. Of course, this area could definitely still use some improvement, as the OnePlus has shown in an OTA fix. The lens copes admirably with changes in lighting, capturing strong detail levels even when battling bright daylight. Meanwhile, the Ozo audio feature seems to work as promised. Voices and other sounds are picked up from all around the phone, and if you watch back while wearing headphones, you'll get the directional surround sound effect. Of course, if it's slightly windy, then you will pick up plenty of distortion using those three mics as well. You can record up to 4K resolution video using the Nokia 8's front-facing camera, something rarely seen on a smartphone even in 2017. Definitely great news if you're a vlogger on the side, especially with that live stream feature. Check out rokomo.com/mobile for the full Nokia 8 camera review and samples and all the rest of it, and don't forget to give us a like and a subscribe and tap that notifications bell to be the first to see it first on our next video. Thanks for watching.